Hey guys, good morning. So we are here in the Contemporary. We got in last night a little late, but we got a good night's rest. And now I'm up a little bit early before everybody else, just to kind of give you guys a walk around of the resort and show you around a little bit. So the Contemporary is an icon in Disney World, one of the two original resorts that were built with the park back in 1971. And it's unmistakable. You know, when you see it, it's right by the Magic Kingdom, literally like a 5-minute walk away. And it's the big A-frame looking building. Like I said, it's very iconic. So we've never stayed here before. Seen plenty of videos about it. Excited to finally get to check it out. So as you can see, when you walk into the lobby, you know, it's not that iconic atrium that's actually on the third floor, but we'll get there. This is the lobby. There's a little coffee bar right off the entryway that serves Joffrey's and any sort of coffee that you might want. And plenty of seating. There's some TVs and stuff for the kiddos to watch cartoons, and the check-in desk. So as you walk back towards the back of the lobby, you actually see Steakhouse 71, which is the premier dining location here at the Contemporary Resort. And walking into Steakhouse 71, you can see the walls are adorned with some really cool old photos of Walt Disney and Roy and the Imagineers from way, way back in the day when they were developing the park. So that's really neat. And there's actually some really cool artwork all throughout the lobby and the atrium, specifically paying homage to Mary Blair, who is an animator. So we'll get a little bit more on her when we go up to the atrium and show you the awesome murals that are up there. So yeah, come on, let's go take a look at the atrium. All right, so we are headed up to the atrium now on the escalators to show you around up there. This is kind of the iconic lobby of the Contemporary. So here we are. There's Mickey, so cute. And boom, there we go. There's the cool Fantasia store. It's like really awesome atrium here. And it's still dark outside. Like I said, I'm up pretty early. It's pretty impressive. The monorail actually runs through here too. Here's part of that mural I was telling you about. Famous artist, animator, and Imagineer, Mary Blair, who is responsible for some of the animation in Peter Pan, Alice in Wonderland, Cinderella, and Imagineering some of the rides like It's a Small World and some other iconic Disney World rides like the Fiesta Boat Ride in Epcot. So definitely check this out. This is like a multi-part mural. So you can see there's another part. And there's just so much to look at. It's absolutely beautiful. There's some really cool Easter eggs in here too. Won't give them away, but definitely come check it out. Of course, here's the other part of the lobby. This is the restaurants. We have the Outer Rim Bar, Chef Mickey's, which is obviously character dining, Contempo Cafe, and this is where we ate at last night. So the monorail runs right here. You'll see it pulling in here in a couple hours when it starts to run. Yeah, look at this. Absolutely massive. Look how high that goes. Look at the colors and the detail. It's just really cool that they preserved this mural and, you know, pay homage to one of the icons of Imagineering, Mary Blair. Shout out to all the women artists out there. You guys do amazing work and are definitely undervalued. So I'm glad the Contemporary kind of gives her flowers. Okay, so we are actually staying in the Garden Tower, not the main building, the smaller three-story satellite building. It's really exciting. Ben and I didn't think that we were gonna get to see the Incredibles renovation that they've done here at the Contemporary, but as you can see, from walking in, there's like subtle Incredibles touches. Very modern looking in here. Cool mirrored ceiling. It smells amazing, obviously, just like any Disney resort. But yeah, you can see from the carpet, Incredibles artwork that's on the wall. This has been renovated. So we'll give you a little room tour and show you that all the little cool Incredibles touches throughout the room. It's pretty exciting. We didn't think that we were gonna get a new renovated room, but looks like they finished the Garden Tower. Hey everybody, welcome to our room, room 5117 here at the Contemporary in the Garden Tower. Excited to show you around because we actually got a renovated Incredibles room. We didn't think that this tower had been renovated, so when we booked, we were just kind of resigned to the fact that, oh, we might get the older rooms, but we're really excited. It's actually the Incredibles remodel, and let's show you around. So starting off with the closet, so you're gonna see a lot of Incredibles themed stuff in the room, obviously, and it's really, really cool. It's like a whole aesthetic. So let me just start off with that. If you're not an Incredibles fan, this may not be as cool of a room as it is to us, because we love The Incredibles, but you have a closet right off the bat. And inside the closet is actually really neat, because you can see, like, it's their suits hanging up, The Incredibles suits. And a lot of really cool little details throughout the room here. You have plenty of hangers that come off the rod. Random recess must, right? They come off the rod. Plenty of space for you to hang stuff up. You have extra pillows and blankets up here. Space to put your luggage and a lot of storage. So you have a lot of drawers in here. Obviously, this resort is meant for families, so you can see those little touches everywhere. A lot of storage space. So that's the closet. Pretty cool. Automatic lights. Very good. Coming in a little further, you have another closet with your safe. Plenty of shelving space. Obviously, this has been lived in a little bit. More drawers down here to store stuff, and a full-length mirror for when you get ready. All right, coming into the room a little more, obviously a coffee maker. That's a great addition to any hotel room, so you don't have to like go out and buy your coffee. It comes with Joffrey's coffee here, an assortment of Joffrey's and cups in the drawer, but Keurig is a very nice touch. Ice holder. You have a lot of cool Edna Mode stuff, like Edna Mode coffee mug. Really neat Incredibles touches all throughout, but here are some different mugs with some cool Easter eggs in them. You have a mini fridge, so that's always nice. Another thing that I wanted to say about this room, there is an abundance of plugs. There are so many outlets. It's great if you have like a lot of chargers. Obviously, we have a lot of logging equipment, cell phones and stuff, so it's nice to have easy access to a bunch of different outlets. All right, so welcome to the room. As you can see, it's pretty good size. One thing to note is it's really good lighting. There's so many lights in here, really bright LED lights that show off the room, and it's not dark at all. Even, you know, even when we have the shades closed, it's not dark at all. It's really bright. We have two queen size beds here. Obviously, some more cool Incredibles touches, right? We got Frozone and we got Edna Mode, right? Really cool characters. These are high beds, so if you want to store your luggage underneath the beds, there's plenty of room underneath. You have the single headboard running across that's shared by both beds. Both beds have these cool reading lights that pop out. This is a really cool touch too, this lamp here. Look, it's the cityscape with the little monorail. That's so cool. One cool thing that I wanted to point out is you have these little nightstands that are built onto the bed here. With more outlets, obviously regular AC adapter outlets and USB plugs. So you can charge your phone right here by the bed or on the other side of the bed. All right, coming over, you have a really big couch. This couch actually does pull out to another bed. So this room sleeps up to 5 people. That'd be a lot, 5 people sharing one bathroom. Yikes, but I mean, if you're a family, why not? You're just staying in here really to sleep, right? Again, you have another cool little touch, The Incredibles with the masks on the pillow. That's pretty neat. And if you look behind the TV with the backlit LED lights, which is a nice touch, this paneling also has cool Incredibles masks. So a lot of really neat details, right? We also have this nice little table to do some work on. And fun fact, it's in the shape of an eye. Hello, Incredibles eye. That's so cool. These rooms come with balconies, which is really, like, we're not used to rooms having balconies because we, you know, obviously stay in a lot of hotel rooms in Vegas. They don't really have balconies. And then another thing, look at the curtains. It's cool. You have, like, Jack-Jack. You have all the Incredibles characters on your curtain. You got Mr. Incredible over here, Elastigirl. Again, a lot of really cool touches. You really do have to like The Incredibles to, like, understand all of the references in here and maybe to appreciate it a little more. It's a very comfortable room, even if you don't like Pixar or The Incredibles. It's a comfortable room, a lot of space, and one more thing to show you, and that's the bathroom. All right, really nice bathroom, very spacious, double vanity sink, big mirror. You have a nice makeup mirror over here as well. You obviously have the Disney H2O products. Nice big glass shower with dual shower heads and a rain shower head. That's been nice, and again, Disney H2O products. If you're familiar with Disney, there's a big culture around the H2O products. I never really understood why, but they do smell pretty good. And I guess since COVID, they've like bolted them onto the wall so no one steals them. You know, that's part of the fun of staying in hotels is taking all the shampoos and conditioners. You can't do that here, but that's fine. And then you have your separate water closet. Again, Disney likes to do this because families usually share the room. So this allows one person to like use the toilet while some other people are maybe showering or getting ready. And there's some cool Jack-Jack art in here while you're using the facilities. So It's really nice. It's well appointed, classy, clean, and we've enjoyed our stay here so far. So definitely highly recommend the Contemporary. It is a little pricey. It's a deluxe resort, so you're paying those deluxe resort prices. However, you do get early park access. This is 5 minutes from the Magic Kingdom walking. There's the monorail that runs right through the Contemporary that you can take to other resorts, or the transportation and ticket center to get to other resorts. So it is conveniently located. There's a lot of conveniences that are built in to the deluxe resort. So it kind of depends on whether or not it's worth it. It depends on what you prioritize, but we've enjoyed our time here. And just for the convenience sake, I would say it's worth staying here. That does it for our Contemporary room tour and resort tour. Short and sweet and to the point. I know. Hope you guys got some good info out of this. This was our first time staying at the Contemporary, and we really enjoyed it. We have one night left. We're actually going to eat dinner at Ohana. That'll be another separate video. Hope you enjoyed this room tour. Hope you enjoyed the resort tour. We really enjoyed staying here at the Contemporary, and can't wait to see you on the next recess.